The Gina and Maddie Podcast.
So, I love on Instagram and Facebook looking at wedding photo fails. Because, you know, you'd spend so much money getting ready for the day. You hire your professional photographer or some of your
friends. They're not cheap either.
Not cheap.
No.
And I do get a good laugh out of some of the fails. Like, you've seen the ones where the whole wedding party walks out on a jetty.
And the bride's legs are just in the air, just falling into the water.
Or the jetty's just slowly going down and all their faces are like, and I'm thinking to myself, the wedding dress and the bridesmaid dresses. Or I love that one. It's a video that's doing the rounds where the young boy passes the ring and he drops the ring and then that knocks the guy who's doing the service, the minister, into the water behind, and then the bride falls in. And that makes me laugh so hard. But looking at it, I am just so thankful then when my husband and I got married 25 years ago last week. As you know, we celebrated the big one.
Congratulations. Well done.
Thank you. There was no phones with cameras on them. Because
were cameras around then?
Yeah, there was cameras.
Okay, it wasn't like someone sketching you?
Black and white. Yeah, there was.
Those old box cameras where you're not allowed to move for 4 hours.
And you're not allowed to smile.
Yeah,
but so one of my friends who was at the wedding, you know, because lots of people sent us their photos and we had our professional photos as well. But she sent me a photo, thank goodness, that she didn't, because remember you could get photos copied at the Photoshop where you'd get them printed?
Yeah, or you take them to the chemist. You pay extra to get it done in 24 hours.
And get two or three copies or whatever.
Yeah, 100%.
Thank goodness she didn't do this. She had a photo of me and I'm throwing the bouquet over my head like this, and she took a photo of that. So the bouquet is in the air, all the girls are behind me. But my wedding dress was all beaded and like the bodice was very, very beaded and quite heavy. So it had a tulle at the bottom, like quite full at the bottom, really tight into the waist and really heavily beaded. It was a really heavy dress. So as I threw the bouquet over my head, the dress held still but the boozies came out.
Oh, God.
Well, the dress was so tight. And, she sent me a photo. And I said, please don't give that to anybody else.
Girls weren't invited to the party.
Can you imagine if that was today? That would have been
everywhere.
On Instagram everywhere. Thank goodness.
What a shame. I mean, thank goodness. Okay, so let's do this. Let's open up the phones. Make Gina's day. You can hear how much she loves hearing about wedding photo fails. Did it happen to you? Were you at the wedding? You were your bridesmaid, a groomsman, something along those lines? Give us a call. We'd love to hear your stories, the wedding photo fails. We'll do that next. You love a wedding photo fail.
I do love a wedding. I'd look them up on Instagram and stuff. I think it's hilarious when the wedding photos go wrong. You just showed me yours, Maddie. Yours were just clear perfection.
Well, that's because my wife is clear perfection. So she makes the photos just sing.
She is very stunning.
Yeah. Can you tell who's in the bad books this morning? On our Facebook as well, you can always get in contact with us. Rachel Holton. Morning, Rach. She said, we had disposable cameras on all of the guest tables. Remember that was a thing?
That's a great idea.
I remember that. That was great. One of my sister's weddings, she did that. One of the tables full of the groom's mates decided to take the camera into the bathroom and take some artistic shots.
No!
We ended up with a whole roll of film of different backsides. And then she got like seven emoji laughing faces. I like this one from Glenn. Glenn, what was the big wedding photo mistake? He said, I showed up.
I actually just remembered another one. I went to a friend's wedding and one of my besties, Max Jackson, was there, and she and I thought it was hilarious to go around everyone's tables because they'd all taken their glasses off to go and dance and they had the cameras as well. So we took photos of ourselves with everyone's glasses.
That is amazing. That's good gear, Jenna Jeffries.
But on the line, we've got Teresa from Somersby. Teresa, did you have a wedding photo fail?
Oh, we sure did.
What happened?
Every single photo, we were married on the beach and every single photo of me came out with black underlines under my eyes and black teeth.
No, nobody told you.
No. The photographer took 8 weeks to edit the photos and then sent them out and I just went, oh, my God.
So hang on a minute. So was the black under your eyes and in your teeth part of, like, the film, like the photographer, or were you, like, smashing poppy seed bread rolls and, like, getting them stuck in your teeth and, like, your mascara is running?
No. It was just pure shadows.
Oh, shadows.
Oh, no.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh,
so thankfully it could be edited out.
Thank goodness.
Oh, my God. Well, you know what? Speaking of black, we are going to, this doesn't make up for that, but we are going to throw you a double pass to see Back in Black, Chronicles and Life of Music of Amy Winehouse, which is in cinemas, so you can go along this weekend and go to the movies on us.
Cool, thank you.
Oh, our pleasure. It is a little fresher today.
It really is.
We saw that, like, how there's had 5 centimetres of snow at Perisher.
Yeah, that, and we're feeling it up here, I reckon. You know how we get the 100%. Get the cool snowy breeze.
Then there was a bit of chat pre-show this morning about, oh, wouldn't it be good to have soup for dinner tonight?
Oh, there's always a food chat going on in our house, in our studio.
Yeah, we love chatting about food and our house. This is our house.
Yeah.
We spend so much time here, we may as well live here.
It's true.
But I did throw out the statement that soup isn't a meal. Soup's like a starter or something you can have for lunch.
Yeah, look at Lozzie's eyes.
Soup's not a meal. It's a drink if you're having it for dinner.
It's just so incorrect. Soup is a superior meal.
It is a good meal.
It's a starter.
It's
for
a starter. The soul.
So when I used to go to Sizzler, it would be what you'd have first, and then you'd go to the rest of the smorgasbord, and then
I'm a bit too young for Sizzler.
Ouch!
I tell you,
sorry.
It
can
depends.
I just get some ice for that burn?
Yeah, depends on the soup, though. So I've just quickly Googled soup, and I am in the mood, I think, to go home and put a slow cooker on. I have found one on Delicious, their website, curried lamb shank. And chickpea soup.
Okay, well, hang on. Now, is it lamb shanks or is it a soup, though? This is the thing.
Well,
you can't call
they're calling it soup. They're calling it. And then I found one, Lizzie. You are going to love this one. Oh. It was pumpkin. Look at her face. Can you describe it to me?
Tell me about it. Paint me a picture.
Pumpkin soup with triple cheese toasty to dip. In
see,
it.
See, yum. You need the triple cheese toasty to make it a meal.
No.
On its own, it's just soup. But with the toasty, it becomes a meal.
I had it yesterday.
Did you?
Yep.
And then you made it yourself.
I did. And this is impressive because, as you know,
you're not really the cook.
No. Yeah. I'm not good. I don't like it. I don't have the time for it. I don't care for it. Anyway.
Oh, your life is so busy.
It's very busy.
Oh, my gosh. All that reformer Pilates.
Yes, yes. but, no, I made this one from, like, a broth, and then I just kept chucking things in.
Because anything can go in.
Yeah, like shallots and, like, garlic and onion and veggies and all this stuff. And it was so good. Like, I could feel myself getting healthier every spoonful.
Hey, I'm not a soup hater. I'm just saying it's not a meal.
It's a meal.
Yeah.
Literally. It is a meal.
I think you do, to be honest, have to add the cheese toasty or something to dip in it.
It did have noodles in it.
Thank you for coming to my show. Yes. Oh, there we go. The Gina and Maddie
podcast. For more great comedy shows like this, head to novapodcasts.com.au.